Corner trim can be launched from the sheet metal toolbar or from the Insert Sheet Metal drop-down menu. Right now, the command is unavailable. The reason this is that this new feature will be dependent on the flat pattern feature, meaning it will only be active in the flattened state. I'll go ahead flatten the part. As soon as I do, the corner trim feature becomes available. I'll click on it, and the corner trim property manager will appear to get started. I can click on each edge that I wish to add relief to, or I can use the Collect All Corners button to have SolidWorks select all of them for me. I can set relief type to use square or bend waist, or I can leave it as circular. Whatever option I decide. In this case, I'll use square relief type. When using the circular or square type, I can use the centered on bend lines option to have SolidWorks center the relief cuts relative to the bend lines. If I use the square type with the centered on bend lines option, I also have the tangent to bend option, which automatically sizes the cut so that it's tangent to the bend lines. I can add fillets to the corners of the reliefs by checking this option and adjusting the radius. And I can adjust is the break corner options. This option allows you to remove material from external edges, and add material to internal edges. To break all of the sharp edges, I'll click on the face of the sheet metal, and SolidWorks breaks every sharp edge that's touching the face. Notice the break option does not override the edges that were added in the relief options section. I can adjust the size of the chamfer or change this to fill it in and adjust the radius. At this point, I'll go ahead and click OK to finish the corner trim feature. It's important to note that all of the settings we specified in this corner trim feature are for the flattened state of the part only.